All right. So yesterday's prompt, day 16, is foul. Oh, I have one. Actually, let's consult the internet about foul. I could do a funny, but let's actually, I have one in mind. I did this before, actually. I doodled this before. But now I kind of want to give it another go. Let's take a look. Okay. Do something funny as well. Oh my gosh, I can't rotate my hand anymore. And this weekend really destroyed my ability to like squeeze anything. I really like this pose. Neat. I like this one. We're gonna Ooh, that's a cute one. Okay. Let's do this one. Try to not do. We're gonna have to skip on backgrounds today. Like putting some comp into background. Honestly, I should really work on prop work. So having a character, having a subject, and something it's interacting with in the future. Hold up. What could it be interacting? We'll stick to this for now. We'll stick to this for now. I have to start incorporating objects into things. So even if they don't have a background, I should really start drawing like objects, like balls and like plates, food, or like a lantern, something that gets me to work on objects. But for now, for today, we're gonna concentrate on. We're just gonna continue working on more like characters. Oh, yeah, we're switching. Okay. All right. I think I made you too stubby, my friend. We need to de-stubify you at some point, but this was good enough. Holy heck, you have no calves. I mean, the character's not human, but skip leg day, that's for sure. This weekend made me feel like I skip leg day all the time. Although, it's really just unfortunate, it's part of getting older. Okay, I don't remember. You check, maybe like. Something like this. I don't remember. All right. Seems all right. We'll take it. It doesn't look like weird. So, oh, I should get used to. I definitely should get used to this. Like this, like hand pose. I do this a lot, actually. Maybe we extend it out a little bit more. Oops. Maybe a little lower. That looks kind of weird. This body is really, it is really big. All right. Yeah, my hands are like somewhat shaking today because I can't squeeze my pen. Skinnier. We need more like curving this, but Next here. Smooth here. We need these to smooth out. And the curves. Definitely round, it's not concave. And the eyes are a lot smaller than this. And then this tapers. You have to get the taper as well. All right. Too bad for a first draft. But let's. Let's go again. Oh, I see what they did. Okay. All right. Whoops. That's some sass, though. Just like subdivide it and like that. And the point, the leg coming out. Oh, actually. Right. Right. Holy, that's not right. That's definitely not right. Whoops. Right. Reason why I did that was because Crud. How the freak? Okay. I see. Pull down the pose. Is like up. So bad. Oh my God. You know, I just realized, I was asking myself, where the heck is the nose? And I just realized the nose is actually part of the beak. It's kind of weird, but it just dawned on me that I'm like, dude, does this character not have a nose? Like, no, it's right on the beak. So I think I should make it a little bit like bigger. It's good enough. Ooh. Man, this is dying to put, like, this is dying for a cape, isn't it? Like, you just want to put a cape on this. Try to hydrate. All right. I lowered the arm a little too low. The problem. Wait. Wait, what the heck just happened? What? I hate when this happens. Like, I don't understand why sometimes the pen, like, just decide to switch it up. Like, I don't even... Oh. Oh. That's because I was using the wrong one. Duh. Okay, hold up. Man. I thought I got it, but I don't think I got it yet. I thought I had it already, but no. Thank you. good enough. Good enough. Stop looking at it. Does that even make sense? Doesn't have to make sense. Oh man, what happened to the side of your face? Okay. Yeah, that's a little sharp. My bad. Hello? Oh my gosh, freaking selection tool. Okay. All right. You just got fatter. It just made you fatter. What happened? That's fine. Okay, just think it's coming from, all right. Sure. Dude, please, don't do that. Not cool. I'll do that later. I don't really know how to do the big things very quickly. Oh no, did I just do what I think I did? Start now. And we're back. Okay. Thank you. I drew one for a doodle way back, and well, gotta draw the dude again. Only this time, I'm not, I'm using, I'm doing a pencil drawing of it. I remember I did one a bit ago when I was still, like, relatively rushing in, a little bit inexperienced. What'd you think of Chicken Little? I actually really like that film. I have some fondness with Chicken Little. This one's a little bit harder than that. I think I'm getting better at this stuff more than the oil stuff. Ooh, the mixing, did not work out as well. Oh my gosh. Now there's the freaking gigantic face. Oh, why is your face so big and blank? Alright. Don't worry. I got this. I've been avoiding the head. The head is really big. It's a ginormous head. But we do want the complexion to be a little bit lighter, probably. Basically doing, I'm like working on imagining volume training. I'm working on how to make my, make my compositions dynamic without using color. Getting a little, trying to figure out how to get the volumes looking interesting without relying too much on. Using color. It helps me eye out, like, how can I get contrast? Like where my dynamic range are. This is my favorite exercise. I think peeps should do this more often. If you're like wanting to get started, it's very helpful. This is a really helpful exercise. Brain is fried. You fry your brain. My right arm is, my right shoulder is killing me. I wasn't really recovered yet. Brains are tastier fried. What are you now, a zombie? Yeah, I've been practicing doing this because it helps with the intuition. So like if you're ever wondering like, oh well, we're not going for accurate lighting, right? We're going for style. Like, where do you want light to beam on your subject to make things look interesting? Whoops. Okay. This is a really good exercise to do that. Try to make something look dynamic, which is black and white. And really, the color does add some volume to stuff, but if you can get your volume looking great, like, this is basically a volume thing. If you can get your volume to look great, you just fill in a color, and if you overlay a color and blend it in using this volume map, it will just look good in general. There are a lot of things when it comes to the different arts. This includes music and whatnot. If you do it enough, you kind of get to the point where you know like a 50 to like it's the whole thing, obviously. All the skills coming together makes for the best looking thing, sure. But there are generally the humans, there are elements that predominantly drives certain things. And for art, it's really the volume. When it comes to the dynamics of an image, it just comes down to volume. Volume accounts for like a really big portion of the impression someone gets from a picture. If you take out all the colors, like if you pick your favorite artist or something, right? An image you like, and just make it black and white. Just take a filter, turn all the color off. You'll see that the volume, just imagining it black and white, the volume, there's a very characteristic pattern of of art that you like. And it really comes down to how you manage contrast, which is very dependent on the volume going across. So you can like accent things. You can go back. I'm just like practicing where I can accent the parts. Like where I would use color to accent. This chicken is the. Yeah. Have you seen Chicken Little, Coffers? Have you ever watched, like, it's this film called Chicken Little, way back. Yeah. So, it's black and white, but if I had to pinpoint anything for an artist to do, in my opinion, in my, like, inexperienced opinion, if you can do this, if this is one of your exercises that you can do very, very well, the difference between this and a colored picture is simply the base color itself. So you take this black and white image and you simply, section off these pieces and put on and blend in to a base color, just a flat color. You've already done all the shading and like light interactions and whatnot right away. So this is a really good exercise for anyone who's still really concerned about if they got an eye for dynamics, like contrasts, you know, all your different... I'm pretty bad at this before. Like, I had no idea where to start. I actually couldn't comprehend how people can create 3D, like, you know, 2D images that have depth with just black and white. Not long ago, maybe like 2 years ago, I wasn't sure how you could do this. It just didn't make sense to me. It made me feel like, how can you imagine this part, right? If they're all black and white, wouldn't everything bleed together? So, like, if you start understanding how you can create boundaries, like occlusions, gradients across the light, I'm imagining the light coming from the top right. And then you can accent occlusions, folds. You can separate the thing. And then a good line, see, a good line art isn't... Oh my gosh. I messed up my layers, so some of it is like on one layer and some... That makes it look really funny. This is the only... I messed up and kept going between the layers, but... You can even take away your line art and it'll still look fine. But I do like the line art. That's why... Don't ever color anything till pure black. But yeah. You know what I can't emulate though? Like lighting with pencil. Maybe. Like I can't do a background yet in it. I am pretty alright with doing a subject now. And I actually feel like it's really rewarding for artwork because, it comes intuitively. It's pretty, this weekend, right? I was out and about and looking around. You'd be surprised how simple the shading is in natural light. Like how rudimentary you can break things down pretty easily. Like I was looking at a tree. We were sitting in the backyard and I had a time to sit down while the other peeps were still playing, and I had a chance to, you know, take a look at the trees and stuff and how light bends. But if you start looking at how they're layered, like, oh, the most of the resolution of this plane is this shade, this volume, and then you slap another intermingling volume on top, a mid-tone, and then a top tone, is that you start viewing the world broken down into various layers. And it all comes from first starting to do tasks like this. How can I imagine that? Let me see if I can actually do this. Just like a simple silhouette thing. I don't know if I can. job covers. Just do it already. I'm waiting. Oh, that's interesting. I can sort of do it. Huh. Can at least imagine what it looks like. And yeah, trying to get the game day with tomorrow. I don't know. I actually don't know. I have to be up in the morning to accompany my father to the gastroenterologist. So I'm not sure. I don't know how tired I'm going to be. He says something, I guess. If he says something about it. Okay. I do want to put a cape on this guy. Pretty badly. How long did I take? This is about 2 hours. Not too bad. I think I should just do this first and then apply the volume later. From now on, maybe I should just do the volume and then worry about coloring it just based on the volume. Oh, I just realized I put the date. I put the date on the incorrect date on the other one. I'll fix that later. So we did this on the 18th. Let's fix that. Wait, hold. No one will ever know. Hold. Why didn't I put this on a different layer? Whoa. What's happening? The buttons are stuck. ton of what did I how did I do the background? It's fine. We need to actually put in the proper dates. I totally labeled these not correctly. On the 17th. Oh wait, we did do this on the 17th. We need to quick. It's fine. I don't have to deal with it. Just gotta relabel these files though. Just Papega? I hope I didn't just Papega. Right. All right. Let's post this. Day 16. Foul. Foul is the prompt. Oops. All right. Well, that was fine. We did it. Two prompts today. Two prompts in one day. We'll catch up with the other prompts. So I'm behind one prompt. So I didn't do yesterday's prompt. This coming day's prompt. Yep. I gotta rest. Like, my arms are kind of still hard. It's really hard from where you, like, form a fist right now. All right. Okay. So, until next time, I'll catch you guys on the next prompt. Probably sometime tomorrow. Next two prompts. And until next time, you know, stay safe, stay healthy, win the lottery for me. And take care. Bye now.